What's up, everybody? Dr. Bonzo back. A quick turnaround. I just did a video yesterday, but I had a topic that was fresh on my mind because I saw it earlier today. So this is a quick hitting high yield review of a medical topic. Not high yield for exams. You don't see this a lot on exams, but you will see this in real life, especially if you do any kind of primary care, urgent care, ER, anything like that. And I'm talking about people who get their ring stuck on their finger. My ring's not actually stuck, but just pretend like it is. So what do you do? Well, one thing you can do is just send them to the emergency room and they'll get these ring cutter things. They'll just slide underneath there, cut the ring, ring's off, right? But if you do that, the person's ring's ruined. They have to, if they really want the ring, they have to go take it to a jeweler, get it melted back down, get it remade. That costs money, obviously, not to mention the fact the ER visit is gonna probably cost a lot more than it costs you in your clinic to be seen. And not only that, when you get the ring melted down and get it kind of remade, it's actually more likely to pop. I've actually had that happen to me one time. So what do you do? Well, all you need is a piece of suture. For our purposes, we're actually gonna use dental floss, which I actually have used in real life before. So what you're gonna do is you take the person's stuck ring and you're gonna take the dental floss and start distally and just feed it underneath that ring. Now, for me, it's really easy. I'm just gonna kind of push my ring up and just slide it underneath there just for the interest of time. But in real life, remember this ring is stuck on there. So you're gonna have to use something like a hemostat or forceps to force that suture or floss underneath that ring and get it to the other side. So once you've done that and you got your ring to the other side, I mean your thread or your suture or whatever to the other side, you're gonna take this part on top of the ring and just start to wrap it really close to the finger. So you notice I'm just kind of wrapping that finger on around, wrapping it on around. I'm gonna show you from the other side. Now I'm not gonna cover kind of every millimeter of the ring. You really want it to be kind of close in real life, but I'm gonna do this again for the interest in the interest of time and just show you how it does and go a little quicker than average. So what you'll notice is happening, and even though my finger's not swollen or stuck, you're gonna see that fluid and kind of edema is getting pushed up. And the more you do it, the more loops you take around that finger, you're gonna notice that all the edema and all the just fluid from that finger is just gonna get pushed. And it's gonna get pushed more and more distal. And then what's gonna happen is that eventually all that edema and fluid is gonna end up getting pushed past the knuckle. Knuckle, obviously, layperson's term. We're talking about that proximal interphalangeal joint or the PIP joint. So once that fluid gets past that PIP joint, it should be relatively easy to get the ring off at that point, right? So you'll notice my finger that you just saw kind of was edematous. Now all of a sudden, that fluid that you saw bulging above all of a sudden is gone for the most part, see? So you just keep on going until you're definitely clear past the knuckle, and then that's when all the fun kicks in. So I'm gonna just keep on going real quick. And then once you do that, and you got all your suture or your dental floss above the ring, you're gonna actually go to that bottom piece that we left hanging out. And all you do here, let's get this out of the way so it doesn't, and I kind of loop the end of it so that I can kind of put it around that finger and keep it out the way. And what you do is you just take that string and you actually just start to unravel it. And you just start to unwind it. And you notice what's happening magically, that ring is sliding up on its own. See? And just keep on unraveling, unraveling, unraveling. And then magically that ring just keeps on coming up. You just keep unraveling. And again, at this point in real life, it's gonna start to get really uncomfortable for the patient. They're but if you kind of go pretty quickly and pretty smoothly and have your suture above the ring spread pretty evenly and have all that edema pushed out, it's pretty quick and pretty easy to do. And then what do you know? All of a sudden, my ring is above that knuckle and just falls on off. So you can do that in real life. Some people suggest using a digital block to do it so the patient doesn't feel too much pain. For me, all the sticks that you have to do to create the digital block, in other words, giving them a nerve blocker, injecting lidocaine in the base of the finger to try to anesthetize that digital nerve. To me, the pain from doing that is longer than the amount of pain they feel right as that ring goes across the knuckle. So if you do a good job of really pushing that edema up, keeping the suture kind of in really tight rows, and then just quickly kind of go up and get that ring over there, again, in my experience has been that people actually have less pain than when I stick them for a digital block. All right, well, there you have it. Another medical topic in 5 minutes or less. See you soon.